And now it's time to put customers on the customer list in our QuickBooks file. Putting in customers is exactly the same as putting in vendors. You have already learned how to put in vendors in previous videos that you studied. It might be a good idea to pause this video and go and review video number 4 from Level 1 Kindergarten QuickBooks. When we put in customers, we will use the Customer Center. That window is exactly the same as the Vendor Center. So if you have it fresh in your memory how to use the Vendor Center, using the Customer Center should be no problem. The only difference with this video is that we will add multiple customers together. Now, before we demonstrate how to do this, let's remind ourselves how to open the Customer Center. From the main menu, click Customer, Customer Center. Notice the Customer Center looks just like the Vendor Center. After we put in the customers, their names will appear on the list in the panel on the left. And when we click on those names, the customer who is selected will have their information shown here. If we wanted to add customers one at a time, we would do the same thing that we did when we put in for vendors. We would click New from the top left, click New Customer, and we would get the New Customer window. We would put in their name and address, and of course we know that each of the different tabs in the New Customer window has additional fields of information to put in for that customer. This should look very familiar to you because this is exactly what we did in a previous video when we put in the vendors. From the top left of the Customer Center, click New Customer and Job. This time in the pull-down menu, choose Add Multiple Customer Jobs. Notice a spreadsheet opens up that looks similar to an Excel spreadsheet. It also has columns with labels on top, and it also has rows going across. Now, normally we could just copy the information from Excel and paste it directly into this spreadsheet, directly into this grid that QuickBooks provides. The only problem is the labels are not lined up the same in the QuickBooks file as they are here in the Excel spreadsheet. So before we can copy and paste, all we have to do is change the columns to match the columns in Excel. Once the column headings match, then we can copy and paste. On the top right of this Add Edit Multiple List window, click Customize Columns. You may notice that there are two columns side by side here in this Customize Columns window. The chosen columns are the columns that are already here. Name and company name, which are the top two, correspond with the leftmost two columns here. Mr. and Mrs. is the third one, first name is the fourth one, and so on. If we close this and scroll slowly to the right, you can see that there are many columns with many fields of information already chosen in this window. We need to remove everything except Bill 2 number 1 and Bill 2 number 2. That's because in our Excel spreadsheet, the only fields we have for our customer information are name, company name, Bill 2 number 1, and Bill 2 number 2. Bill 2 number 1 and 2 are way over to the right, and if we scroll back, we can see there are many fields between those two and the first two fields that we need, name and company name. So, how do we manage this? Click Customize Columns, and in the chosen columns, we're simply going to remove all of the columns that we don't need. Click on the third one down, Mr. and Mrs. Click Remove. First name, remove. Now, keep clicking Remove until you get to Bill 2-1 and Bill 2-2. Do not remove this one. Do not remove this one. Click on Bill 2 number 3 and click Remove, Remove, Remove. Now, the only remaining columns here after we click OK, these four remaining columns are the same as the four columns here. Now we are able to copy and paste. Simply select all the data, click Copy from the Excel ribbon, go back to QuickBooks, click in the top right, right click, paste. Now, all the fields of information from our Excel spreadsheet are exactly the same as what's in the corresponding field in the QuickBooks file. When we click Save the Changes and then click OK, we then close and we notice these three customers have been added to the Customer Center. Notice when we click on a customer name, their address comes up, and later when the customer is selected, you will see all the transactions for that customer. If you want to be sure the data went into the customer record properly, you could double-click a particular customer and go to the Edit Customer window and take a look at how the information was put in.